So let's now look at the last step. Once again, let us look now in the last step at the DA converter. Yeah, so there's a DA converter and the output. So the question is it possible actually to reconstruct the signal? To reconstruct the analog signal. So if this is obviously not possible, then the whole signal processing story won't work. So the good news is it works, but we need to show basically quickly how and how this has been proven. So let's basically describe our signal as a superposition of different sine waves. So let's say cosine and then pi fi t plus theta I. So these are all the frequencies in the signal, and obviously all these frequency, so f, if we have a maximum frequency here, this f max needs to be obviously smaller than half of the sampling rate. So we know this, so otherwise it won't work. So we've got only frequencies which are half of the sampling rate. Phi here, or phi in the English version, phi is just a phase factor. So we can also represent sines here in this way. This is the amplitude of the frequency. Yeah, and so we are essentially if we have a signal, maybe which looks like that we are approximating this with different waves. Yeah, maybe a higher frequency wave here, and so on and so on. And so we're just doing a superposition of this. So the so-called sampling theorem states that if a signal is constructed this way, it is possible to completely reconstruct this. Okay, so let's have a look how this could be done. Let's write this here properly. How? So let's take a new sheet of paper for that. So how can we reconstruct our original signal? So remember our digital signal. Is just a sequence of different pulses, yeah. So something like that, which represents our signal, and the original signal was probably more something like this. So we would like to basically come back to this analog signal. So how do we do this? And the idea is the following. So we take a function g of t, which looks like this, 2 pi and then f max t divided by 2 pi f max t. So the idea is to take this function now here, so that's our maximum frequency as defined previously, and so we take this function here and put this function here on every of these samples here. So how does it look like if we just plot this function in Python?
So what we need to do is we just need to create a vector with lint space, let's say from -3 to 3, and with 100 samples, and then we just plot this. Plot, and so then we have here the sine function, and that's 2 pi multiplied by t, and then divided by 2 pi, and then t as well. So that's essentially just the more or less Bok standard sync function what we see here.
So let's go back to our drawing here. So this means that at every point here, this function will generate something like this. And so if we're adding up these functions now, then this resulting sine wave, this resulting curve here is reconstructed from this. So if we're using this function here, then we can essentially do that. The question is, so what is this here actually? And this is essentially an ideal low-pass filter. It's an ideal low-pass filter with cutoff at fmax. The problem is with ideal low-pass filters, ideal low-pass filters don't exist in the real world, but we can always generate an approximation of these low-pass filters just by creating a real world low-pass filter. This is usually done that we have our AD converter and then a low-pass filter just at the output.